Thank you so much for that applause, and thank you to the Warrensburg Community Band for joining us on tonight's program. How about one more round of applause for the Community Band? My name is Corey Seepy. It is an honor to be nearing the end of my first semester here alongside Dr. Bonner. We're so grateful, as Mark said, that you're here tonight. And this is a special concert, if you couldn't tell, not just because the Community Band is here, but because it is the first ever First Lady's Holiday Concert number one. And number two is tomorrow night downstairs in Hart with the choirs. So we're deeply grateful to have First Lady Robin Best here, as well as Roger Best. And if you all are out there, thank you so much for being here. We're so supported here in the arts, and specifically in music at UCM. So thank you for sponsoring this concert, and for all of the events that are happening this week. Jingle on the Quad, there's a parade on Friday. It's just a great way to kick off the holiday season here in Warrensburg. Also thanks to Provost Bridgman and Dean Sawyer for being here and for your support. It's a great place for music, and you'll hear more of that in just a moment. The first piece with the wind ensemble was called Celebration, for obvious reasons. We have a lot to celebrate this time of year. The second piece is celebratory in a much more ancient sense. It was originally entitled O Magnum Mysterium, which translates to O Mighty Mystery. It's a setting by Jennifer Higdon of an ancient Latin text, originally for choir. You will not hear the choir tonight, obviously. The piece Mysterium, is based on that choral original. And it's peaceful and serene and celebratory of the gentleness and stillness, not unlike Silent Night that you already heard. So we hope you enjoy Higdon's Mysterium. Isn't that stunning music? Hopefully you could imagine a choir singing, and you don't have to imagine. Tomorrow night, 7 o'clock, Hart Recital Hall, First Ladies Holiday Concert number 2, with my dear colleague Jackson Thomas. Amazing flute playing. By the way, Dr. Higdon was a flute player, is now one of two preeminent living American composers you heard, Adolphus Hale Storck, Jennifer Higdon, totally contrasting styles of music, but celebrating music in two totally different tonal realms and feeling realms. It is the season. This next piece is called Variants on a Medieval Tune, and I promise many of you will recognize the medieval tune. It's often known or associated with the English text, Good Christian Men Rejoice. And it's very festive, it's another ancient carol. So if you sense a bit of a theme with old school carols reimagined, you are very astute. So it's called Variants because it's a series of variations on that theme. Some are uplifting, some are a bit dark and intense, and it takes you on a whole musical journey. So we hope you enjoy Norman Delajoyo's Variants on a Medieval Tune.
Thank you. Thank you.
What a journey on one simple tune, isn't it? So many different styles. One of the things we love about music is every style is valid. Every different color and tempo and rhythm and genre, it's all so meaningful, especially this time of year as we get to celebrate. This is a celebratory moment, but also a bittersweet moment. Before I invite our graduate conductor to conduct the last piece on this section, there are a few people for whom this is their final wind ensemble concert here at UCM. And it breaks my heart that we've only had a few months together, but all five of these people are wonderful. One of them is going on to graduate, and that is the first person I'll announce. The other four are going on to student teach next semester, so we will miss them dearly. These are our graduating wind ensemble students in December. Please hold your applause until you hear all five names. So without further ado, and I hope I pronounced them all correctly, Evelyn Kirtley on bassoon, who's graduating. Please hold your applause. I know it's hard, it's very hard. Paige Bacchus on clarinet. Christopher Smith on clarinet. And in the flute section, Allie Holsey. And last but not least, Elizabeth Munsterman. Please congratulate your graduates. Last piece on the wind ensemble portion before we have two very special holiday closers. Please welcome to the stage our amazing graduate assistant, Joey Carter. Thank you. thank you again for joining us this evening. It's been a blast performing for you. We hope to see you at future music events. If I didn't mention it already, we've got one tomorrow night downstairs in Harborside Hall at 7 o'clock. And the choirs here are sensational, so you won't want to miss that. This last piece, how many of you have not heard Sleigh Ride by Leroy Anderson? All right. Well, you're in for a treat tonight, because I'm not going to conduct this one. Dr. Bonner's not going to conduct this one. And Pat Setzer's not going to conduct this one. There was an event called Giving Tuesday a few days ago, and there was a wonderfully generous donation to UCM from across the community, and I think around the globe, I hope. Out of people who donated, there was one lucky name drawn, and that name is Annie Golob, who just so happens to work here at UCM, which was great because I was able to meet Annie earlier today and said, hey, you get to conduct Sleigh Ride to close our concert. So without further ado, Annie works in the Missouri Safety Center here on campus, and we're so grateful that she is brave enough to be our special guest donor and guest conductor of Sleigh Ride this evening. So please welcome Annie to the stage.